let's derive the mean and variance of the Poisson distribution. Here's the probability mass function for the Poisson distribution, and I sometimes take a bit of a shortcut and write this as p of little x. And a Poisson random variable can take on any non-negative whole number value. And you may have been told previously that mu, or the mean, or expected value of a Poisson random variable x is equal to lambda, and sigma squared, or the variance of a Poisson random variable x, is also equal to lambda. For the Poisson distribution, the mean and variance are the same. And in this video, I'm going to mathematically derive that mean and that variance. We're going to need to use this, the series expansion of e raised to the a, where e is the mathematical constant and a is some other constant. I'm going to take this as a given in this video, and there's lots of information online if you're looking for further explanation. The expectation of a discrete random variable x is equal to the sum over all possible values of x times its probability of occurring. And for the Poisson distribution, that works out to this, x times the probability mass function for the Poisson distribution summed over all possible values of x. We're summing over the values of x here, and e to the minus lambda does not involve x, so I'm going to take that outside of the summation. And we're left with this. First, note that when x is equal to 0, this whole term is 0, and so we can change this lower limit of summation to x equals 1. And we'd like to cancel out this x with part of this x factorial in the denominator if we can, and recall that x factorial is the product of x times x minus 1 times x minus 2 all the way down times 2 times 1. And another way of writing this then would be x times x minus 1 factorial. And so I can cancel this x with the first term there, and we'd be left with x minus 1 factorial in the denominator. And we'll soon see that since we've got this x minus 1 factorial in the denominator, it's going to make things a little easier to work with if we have lambda raised to the x minus 1 in the numerator. And so I'm going to take one single lambda out front, and we'll be left with lambda raised to the x minus 1. It's getting a little messy here, so let's clean this up. And so we've shown that our expectation of x is equal to this. And we're going to see in a minute that our summation here is the series expansion of e to the lambda. But to make that a little clearer, I'm going to let y equal x minus 1. Put a y factorial and a lambda to the y here. But if I do that, I have to make sure I have the proper limits of summation. And when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. And as x tends to infinity, y also tends to infinity, so we can leave the infinity. And so our expectation of x boils down to this expression. But recall that the series expansion of e to the a is this. And that is exactly what we have here with a equaling lambda. And so this summation here is equal to e to the lambda. And so our expectation of x is equal to lambda times e to the minus lambda times e to the lambda, which is lambda times e to the minus lambda plus lambda, and that is simply lambda times e to the 0, which is, of course, lambda. So the expectation or mean of a Poisson random variable is lambda. What about the variance? The variance of a random variable x is defined to be the expectation of x minus mu squared. And for a discrete random variable, that's equal to the sum over all possible values of x minus mu squared times the probability of that value of x occurring. But it's usually easier if we work with this relationship down here. This relationship comes in handy in a lot of spots. The variance is equal to the expectation of the square of x minus the square of the expectation of x. And we already have the expectation of x, we just worked that out. So the question boils down to finding the expected value of x squared. For discrete random variables, the expectation of x squared is equal to the sum over all possible values of x of x squared times its probability of occurring. And for the Poisson distribution, that works out to this. But here we cannot cancel this x squared term with terms in the denominator. We can cancel one of these x's, but not both. So we're going to use a little trick here, one that's useful when we have an x factorial in the denominator. We need to find the expectation of the square of x, but first we're going to find the expectation of x times x minus 1. And what this does for us is it makes these two terms easy to cancel with terms in the x factorial in the denominator. And it's also going to be easy to find the expectation of x squared, because this is simply equal to the expectation of x squared minus x. So once we have this, it's going to be quite easy to find the expectation of the square of x. First, let's again bring this e to the minus lambda outside of the summation. Now let's note that when x is equal to 0, this whole term goes to 0, and when x is equal to 1, we have an x minus 1, so again, this whole term is equal to 0. So we can change this lower limit of summation to x equals 2. And since x factorial can be written as x times x minus 1 times x minus 2 factorial, I'm going to cancel x times x minus 1 with these first two terms, and we are going to be left with x minus 2 factorial in the denominator. And here's what we're left with. And since we've got x minus 2 factorial in the denominator, we'd like to have lambda raised to the x minus 2 in the numerator. So then we can use the series expansion of e that we used before. So I'm going to take a lambda squared out front and change this to lambda raised to the x minus 2. And here's the result. And we're going to see in a moment that again, this summation turns into e to the lambda. To make that a little bit easier to see, I'm going to let y equal x minus 2. And then I'm going to get a y factorial in the denominator and a lambda raised to the y in the numerator. And again, I'm going to have to change this lower limit of summation from x equaling 2 to y equaling 0, because when x is 2, y is 0. And here's what we're left with. And this summation is exactly the same summation we had before, the series expansion of e to the lambda. And so the expectation of x times x minus 1 is equal to lambda squared times e to the minus lambda times e to the lambda. These two multiplied together are going to give us 1, and so the expectation is equal to lambda squared. And so we showed that the expectation of x times x minus 1 is equal to lambda squared, which implies then that the expectation of x squared minus x is equal to lambda squared. By properties of expectation, we can split that up and say that the expectation of x squared minus the expectation of x is equal to lambda squared. But we just found this out to be lambda. And so the expectation of x squared is equal to lambda squared plus lambda. And we know that the variance of x is equal to the expectation of the square of x minus the square of the expectation of x. And we just found that the expectation of x squared is equal to lambda squared plus lambda. And we found earlier that the expectation of x was lambda. So we subtract off lambda squared, and we are left with lambda. And so the variance of a Poisson random variable is equal to lambda. And here we showed that for a Poisson random variable, the mean and the variance are both equal to lambda.